Color of power, said red. I'm the strongest. Never. I'm the color of prosperity. Who can beat me? Said green. The oceans and the skies bear my toll. I'm the best, said blue. The colors in nature were having an argument as to who was the greatest of them all. Voices rose, emotions boiled over, and they came to blows. And very soon, a pitched battle had ensued. Suddenly, the sky turned dark. Thunder broke, lightning flashed, and it began to pour. The colors screamed. The rain was washing them away. They quit arguing and started desperately seeking ways to survive. My dear friends, as I was narrating the story to you, our planet Earth and the universe that we belong to is on a journey where with every passing second, we are moving farther and farther away from each other. It is a journey of divergence. It's sad because once we were all one, a billion stars and a million galaxies in one tight embrace, together. Why did divergence become the norm? Well, if you think about it, not only in the macro world, but even in our micro worlds, we are diverging. Take a look at your Facebook friend list. Look at those who you have meaningful relationships with. I am sure that a majority of these close contacts would be people who are very similar to you. They may speak the same language as you. They may talk, pray, eat, dress, and maybe even think like you. You are moving around with mirror images of yourself. You huddle together, form groups, and build walls around these groups, and look at the people outside these walls with prejudiced eyes. Just like planets with their own private satellites, diverging from other celestial bodies, we too are, sadly. And we know why this is happening. Long, long ago, when our forefathers used to live in caves and forests, there was no law to speak of. So if I saw a stranger, there, you, I don't know you, you could be dangerous. You could be here to steal my food. You could be here to steal my cave, to hurt my family. So every unknown, dissimilar face, yours, yours, and yours, is the face of an enemy, to be kept away, to be suspected. To our unevolved primitive brains, divergence was the secret to survival. In a small experiment, more children were asked which they loved better, marshmallows or candies. Then they were shown many teddy bears, and they said that some of these bears loved marshmallows and the others loved candies. Later, when asked to choose a toy, all the kids who loved teddy bears, all the kids who loved marshmallows wanted bears who loved it too. They didn't even look at the bears who were supposed to love candies. And later, when a make-believe fight was acted out between the bears, they roared and cheered when their bears were beating up the other ones. The pain and wails with someone of dissimilar tastes didn't matter at all to these kids. See how primitive we are, even today. But isn't this an outdated mentality? Yes, and I have three reasons why it is so. Can anyone name this tribe? Of course, it's the Maasai tribe in Africa. When did man first set foot on the earth? Yes, 1969. Where is this? Many people think it's Hogwarts, but it's actually the dining hall of Howard University. The set of the Great Hall of Hogwarts was taken from Howard University. What do the Maasai tribe, the moon landing, and the Howard University have in common? Well, the Maasai tribe is a tribe in Africa, which is now facing extinction. In a few more decades, there'll be no more. Because they do not mingle with the outside world. So when changes come forth, in the environment, in the availability of food, in health issues, they try the same age-old ways and fail. All those solutions are right around the corner. Divergence kills. When the first rocket to the moon was conceived, people from all walks of life were called to put forth their ideas. So the design tables had around it teachers, scholars, doctors, miners, engineers, fishermen, and together, with different and even conflicting ideas, they pulled it off. But the design table where the space shuttle Challenger was conceived had only engineers around it. We can do it. We will suffice. And that got us this song, The Final Countdown.
Experience, be enriched with the beauty of diversity.
Stop them there. Irrespective of who it is, if anyone makes a generalized comment about people who are different, other genders, other religions, other nationalities, other castes, have the courage to go up to them and say, "Sir, you're so primitive," or "Ma'am, you're racist." Dissolve your prejudices. If you feel prejudiced about someone, smile. Say hi and get to know them, and watch your prejudice melting away. And we have to do these three things until we recognize, within the most dissimilar frame, the soul of a brother, of a sister, of a brother. Do you want to know what happened to our friends? Colors. Well, when all else failed, they joined hands, stood shoulder to shoulder and neck, and fought the deluge. Until they rose up into the sky to form that one united beam of light, a sparkling rainbow in the sky. Let us leave divergence to the macro world, and in our own tiny micro worlds, let us unleash the magic of convergence. Thank you.